Hi, and welcome back to my channel, Plain Not Jane. I am Plain Not Jane, and you, my friend, have tuned into this week's 7. This week's 7 is a video series highlighting lessons learned and observations made in my life over the last 7 days. And this week's 7 starts now. Number 1. I used my sewing machine and nobody got hurt. Now, it did make some crazy noises and started beeping and shaking, and I don't know, like it was beeping and shaking, but I figured out what I was doing wrong. I just needed to increase the tension on my thread, and I did have to look at the little diagram on the top to figure out how to wind the bobbin, because I haven't wound the bobbin in so long. But I successfully made a couple of pillows, and I even threw together a ribbon belt for Honey Badger in like 3 minutes. So that's giving me a little confidence boost, and I think I wanna maybe learn how to do some of the other things with that machine other than the straight stitches. Number 2. I don't know why. Actually, I think I do know why. The last few times I have hurt my back, it has been during bath time. For some reason, I keep making the mistake of picking up one of those heavy toddlers and twisting at the same time, which throws my back out of whack every single time. Now, I enjoy bath time, and as much as it pains me, I might have to relinquish that privilege to my husband or our older girls, because I can't afford to be on a heating pad for a week at a time. Number 3, fear serves a purpose. 2 Timothy tells us that God doesn't give us a spirit of fear, but we still experience it. Matter of fact, this past week, I experienced that feeling of fear a lot. Now, I'm not talking about fear like a fear of clowns, because clowns really are creepy. I'm not talking about fear of rabbits, because rabbits really are creepy. I'm not talking about fear like a fear of mascots, because, I mean, let's be honest, those big nun-looking eyes really are creepy. I'm talking about that I want to ball up in the darkest corner of my closet and cry in the fetal position type of fear. I'm talking about that frozen in your footsteps, can't think straight, can't scream because your voice is frozen type of fear. I'm talking about that instant overwhelmed and afraid type of fear. I was praying, I was meditating on scripture, but I was still feeling fear, and I could not figure out why. Lord, why am I experiencing fear? Then it dawned on me. Fear is an indicator that you need to turn something over to God. Fear indicates that I have a concern that I haven't given to Him. And we already know that He says, cast all our cares upon Him because He cares for us. Fear is just a red flag to let me know that I can't handle it, but He can. Number 4. There are 37 days until Christmas. Number 5. I've gotten my very first Merry Christmas from a complete stranger, and it kind of caught me off guard, but it made me genuinely smile, like from the inside out, like I really got the warm fuzzies. It's that time of year. Number 6. Hubby cranked up the fireplace this week, and I could not be happier. It is something about the smell of wood burning, and even the heat that comes from the fireplace is different from the heat that comes from the central air unit. Like, it is just, I mean, literally it's a warm feeling, but it really makes me feel at home and loved when I smell and feel a fireplace. And I think it's because it reminds me of my grandparents so much. And finally, number 7. I struggle with self-care. Over the last few weeks, my stress levels have gone up and up and up and up. And this past week, I reached a brand new stress threshold. I was wound up tight, but I thought that I was still functioning well and functioning efficiently. But then I started noticing that I was losing my train of thought more often. And I was struggling to find words. Like, I'd be saying something and I would just completely forget what word I needed to use next. But even with that, I kept going, kept putting myself on the back burner, you know, just get it done. I'll relax, you know, do something for me later. Let me get this done first. But then I hit a wall. I could not focus or concentrate. And I figured that out when I was sitting down to do one of my school assignments, and I could not figure out how to even get started. Like, I literally sat in front of my computer screen and cried like a brand new baby because I felt so dumb and so incompetent. Like, I just could not figure out how to get started. And the assignment really wasn't that hard, but I just couldn't concentrate or focus enough to get it done. So I started thinking, why am I so spent? Why am I wound up so tight? Well, I was wound up for a variety of reasons, but the most glaring issue was that I had not stopped to take care of me. I had not done any real self-care in a while. Once again, I was not making myself a priority. And I'll be honest, I never really thought that getting in a habit of doing self-care could be so difficult. And it sounds crazy, but some of us really do struggle with taking care of ourselves. We have no issue taking care of everybody else, making sure that everyone else has what they need, when they need it, before they need it, how they need it. But then when it comes to ourselves, we struggle to do the same thing. And I'll be honest, at this point, I don't have a quick fix. But I do have a renewed sense of urgency. And it has really been highlighted over the last few weeks just how important it is for me to get a handle on my own self-care. Alright, that's been this week's 7. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, give this video a good old thumbs up. And if you didn't, keep on going and don't come back. Also, make sure you click below to subscribe to my channel for more videos like this week's 7, DIY projects, cooking videos, and good old family foolery. So until next time, have a happy and blessed Thanksgiving. Bye-bye.
This is going fast. This is going fast. It's going fast. This is going fast.